Gayatri, and in this video we will learn what is the effect of significant figures in elementary arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So that thing we will understand through this video. Okay, let's start. What is the effect of significant figures in multiplication and division? First we will see for the multiplication and division, this type of mathematical operation. Okay, so suppose we take one example, suppose this is one oil pastel box, and the length of this box is suppose 12 inch. Okay, 12 inch, and the width of this box is 4 inch. So we will not take round off because we have to understand the thing. So we will take some the value after the decimal also. So suppose we are taking length of the color box is 12.08, I'm taking, okay, that much inch. Okay, and width of color box is suppose I'm taking not 4 exactly, suppose I'm taking 4.3 inch. So what is the area of the color box? I have to multiply this length into width. So 12.08 is multiplied with 4.3. So this will be how much? This will come 51.944, that much inches square. That is the area come. So now we have to take how much the significant digits in that area we have to take. So here we are multiplying these two figures, these two values. So here how many significant figures are there? Here there are 4 significant figures. 1, 2, 3, 4. Because this 0 is coming after the decimal, and if decimal also is not there, then also it is in between of 2 non-zero digits. So okay, so this 0 also giving you a significant figure. So there are total 4 significant figures in the length. And width how many? There are only 2. 2 significant figures. So here we are taking the least significant figures of the values for the multiplication. If suppose you are multiplying 4, 5 values, so in that is the least significant figure in the values. So so here this is the 2 is the least significant figures. So we have to go up to the 2 significant figures. So these 2 only we have to take. Now we can round off that, so it will be 52 inch square. So that is the area of the color box. Okay, now if I am seeing for the division, so suppose we are knowing the area of the color box is this, and in this color box we are having some colors. Okay, so suppose I am taking the area of this one color, and suppose we are assuming the area of this one color is area of one single color is 2.8 inch square. That I am assuming, just assuming. So I have to find how many colors will be in this box. So for that we have to divide this area with this area. Okay, so then only we can find how many the colors. So colors will be equals to here one more important thing we have to see. Whatever rounding off we are doing, that we have to do in the final calculation. Here the question was only we have to find the area of the color box, so here I have round off, but here we have to find the how many colors in the box. So here final calculation will be when we are finding the color after the division. So it will be the first multiplication and then after the division. So it will be like this: 12.08 into 4.3 divided by this 1.28. This will be gives you the final picture. So this will be 51.944 divided by 1.28. Here whatever rounding off we will do, that we will do at the end of the calculation. Okay, so what will be the answer? Answer is 40.58125. This is the values coming. So now here we have to see how many values we can take, how many significant digits we can take. So here also how many values are there? This is one value, and we know this 2 value and this 3 value. We are using these 3 values for finding the number of colors. in the color box. Okay, so here in the first value we are having three significant digits. Okay, in the second value we are having four significant digits. In third value we are having two significant digits. So in which value we are having the least significant digits and how much it will be? So in the third value we are having the least significant digits and which are 2. So here also we can go up to 2. So now we can take up to only 4 significant digits. So here we can round off. So it will be 41. So 41 colors in the color box that we are finding. So okay, but here it is showing 25 sets. So whatever area we have taken, I think it's very small. And okay, that area of the color box also it may be wrong. So okay, so like that we have to choose the significant figures in a multiplication and division. In multiplication division also, whatever the least digits are in the value, whatever values are given. If in a multiplication 5 values are given, so in all the 5 values which is having the least significant digits, that we have to take in the final calculation. And for same thing for the division also. Now we will see for the addition and subtraction. Suppose I am taking same example of this color box, and we know the length of the color box is 12.08 inch. Okay, and width of color box is 4.3 inch. So suppose we are calculating the perimeter of the same color box. So perimeter of color box will be 2 times length plus width. So this is coming 2 times 12.08 plus 4.3, and this value is 32.76, that much inch. Okay, so here what will be the significant figures? So here the rule is we have to see the minimum digit, significant digit after the decimal. So here there are 2 values. This is 1 value, this is 2 value. Here there are 2 values. In these 2 value we have to see the significant digits after the decimal. So here how many digits are there? Here there are 2 significant digits are after the decimals. And here how many? Here 1 digits are after the decimal. 1 digit is significant digit. So whatever the least significant digits after the decimal, that we have to take in the final for addition and subtraction both. So here the least one is 1. So after the decimal up to this we can go. So the answer will be 32.8, because now we will round off this. So answer will be 32.8 inch. Okay, like that. And but if we are doing multiplication, so we can go up to 33. It will be, the answer will be 33 if it is the multiplication. But if it is the addition, the answer will be 32.8. So that is the difference between these two. Okay, so now if I am taking the subtraction example, so subtraction, suppose same 2 values I am taking, length and width, and I am subtracting these 2 values. So subtraction 12.08 minus of 4.3, answer will be 7.78, that much inch. Okay, so here again the same rule will be valid, whatever I have done for the addition. So here after the decimal we have to take only 1 significant digit, so it will be the 7.8 inch. We can round off like that. This is the subtraction of these 2 digits. So these are the rule for the multiplication, division and addition and subtraction. For multiplication and division we have to see in the total how many significant digits, and which is having the least significant digits, that we have to put in the final calculation. And in addition and subtraction we have to see after the decimal which value is having least significant figures, least significant digits, that we have to take in the final answer. So okay, so in these 3 videos, if you are having any doubt about the significant figure, what does significant figures means, and what are the thumb rules, if any rules you are not able to understand, and what is the multiplication, subtraction, whatever operation, that the arithmetic operation I did, so in that how much we have to take, if you are having any doubts, so you can ask through the comment box. And if these videos are helpful for you, so please like and subscribe. Thank you very much for listening.